Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to discuss about blood supply of the brain and the spinal cord. Blood supply is continuously needed to the brain because of its high metabolic demands for oxygen and glucose. The brain is highly sensitive to the hypoxia, that is inadequate amount of oxygen, and also hypoglycemia, that is low levels of glucose in the blood. So the consciousness is lost within 10 seconds of cessation of blood flow. And if the state continues, an irreversible brain damage starts to occur at about 4 minutes and is completed within 10 minutes. So the brain is one of the most metabolically active organs of the body, as it depends on aerobic metabolic glucose. Cerebrovascular diseases like thrombosis, embolism and hemorrhage are the third most common cause of the death, and the neurological signs depend on the site of lesion. So therefore, you must have adequate knowledge of blood supply of the brain for proper diagnosis and treatment of the diseases. Blood supply of the central nervous system. We have two systems. One is carotid system. 80% of the blood is supplied to the brain by carotid arteries. And vertebral system, vertebrobasilar system, 20%. That means we have two vertebral arteries and two internal carotid arteries. The vertebral arteries, they unite and they form basilar artery. An internal carotid artery, they originate from the bifurcation of the common carotid. So vertebrobasilar system, major artery superior to the heart, that is brachiocephalic trunk, left common carotid and left subclavian. So subclavian artery, it gives off a branch, which is known as the vertebral artery. The right subclavian gives off right vertebral artery, whereas left subclavian gives off left vertebral artery. So the vertebral arteries, they passes through foramen transverse cerium of the cervical vertebrae and eventually at the lower border of the pons, they unite and they form basilar artery. Vertebrobasilar system consists of upper cervical, spinal cord. That means the vertebrobasilar system supplies the following structures: the upper cervical, spinal cord, brainstem and the cerebellum, most of the thalamus, hypothalamus, posterior and medial parietal lobes of the brain, medial and inferior temporal lobes, occipital lobes, splenium of the corpus callosum. Vertebral artery. Vertebral artery, it is a branches of the first part of the subclavian artery. Ascends neck in the transverse process of the upper six cervical vertebra. Enters the skull through foramen magnum and enters the subarachnoid space. It passes medially on the medulla oblongata at the lower border of the pons, joins the vessel of the opposite side to form the basilar artery, as you can see in this diagram. Blood branches from the vertebral artery, we have the meningeal artery, the meningeal branch supplies the meninges, posterior spinal artery. You can see here the posterior spinal artery and anterior spinal artery, then medullary arteries, then posterior inferior cerebellar artery. Basilar artery, it is formed by the union of the right and left vertebral arteries. This is the basilar artery. Ascends in the groove on the anterior surface of the pons, but the upper border of the pons divides into two posterior cerebral arteries. That is, termination of the basilar artery is the posterior cerebral artery. Okay. Branches. Pontine branches, they supply the pons. Labyrinthine artery supplies the internal ear. Branches from the basilar artery. Pontine artery supply the pons. Labyrinthine artery supplies the internal ear. Anterior inferior cerebellar artery supplies anterior and inferior part of the cerebellum. You can see here, this is anterior inferior cerebellar artery. It supplies anterior and inferior part of the cerebellum. Superior cerebellar artery supplies the superior surface of the cerebellum, pons, the pineal gland, and superior medullary vellum. Then we have posterior cerebral artery, which is the termination of the basilar artery. Posterior cerebral artery at the level of the midbrain, the basilar artery bifurcates to form posterior cerebral artery. As you can see in this diagram, it is shown in yellow color. It curves laterally and backwards around the midbrain. Here it is joined by the posterior communicating branch of internal carotid artery to form the circular pilus. In this diagram, you can make out that the posterior cerebral artery joins with the posterior communicating artery branch from the internal carotid artery to form circular pilus. Then we have PICA. The posterior inferior cerebellar artery, it is the largest branch from the vertebral artery, supplies the superior surface of the vermis and central nuclei of the cerebellum, medulla oblongata, choroid plexus of the fourth ventricle. Anterior inferior cerebellar artery, it passes posteriorly and laterally, supply the anterior and inferior parts of the cerebellum, and also lateral part of the pons, upper part of the medulla oblongata. Blood supply of the spinal cord. The spinal cord receives its arterial supply from three small arteries, two posterior spinal arteries and one anterior spinal arteries. Remember, they will ask you in Viva also that what is the blood supply of the spinal cord. There are two posterior spinal arteries, one anterior spinal artery. Longitudinally running arteries are reinforced by small segmental arranged arteries that arise from the arteries outside the vertebral column and enter the vertebral canal through intervertebral foramina. So these vessels, anastomose, are the surface of the spinal cord and send branches into the substance of the white and gray matter. So these are the arteries serving the spinal cord, the two posterior spinal arteries and one anterior spinal artery. Anterior spinal artery is formed by the union of two arteries, each of which arises from the vertebral artery inside the skull. The anterior spinal artery then descends on the anterior surface of the spinal cord within the anterior median fissure. Branches from the anterior spinal artery enter the substance of the spinal cord and supply the anterior two-thirds of the spinal cord. Posterior spinal arteries arise either directly from the vertebral arteries inside the skull or indirectly from the posterior inferior cerebellar arteries. Each artery descends on the anterior surface of the spinal cord close to the posterior nerve roots and given off dips of branches that enter the substance of the cord. The posterior spinal arteries supply the posterior one-third of the spinal cord. Posterior cerebral artery. The posterior cerebral artery It supplies the part of the thalamus and the lentiform nucleus, midbrain, the pineal gland, and medial geniculate body. Okay. So posterior cerebral artery, it supplies the thalamus, lentiform nucleus, midbrain, pineal gland, and medial geniculate bodies. Then there are cortical branches. The posterior branches to the lateral and medial surface of the occipital lobe of the brain, optic radiations and visual cortex and splenium of the corpus callosum. Anterior branches to the inferolateral, medial and medial surface of the temporal lobe and hippocampal formation and posterior fornix. Choroidal branches supplies choroid plexus and lateral and third ventricle, lateral and third ventricle. Internal carotid artery, it begins at the bifurcation of common carotid, ascends in the neck, perforates the base of the skull by passing through the carotid canal of the temporal lobe. It runs horizontally to the cavernous sinus, enters into the subarachnoid space, turns posteriorly to the medial end of the lateral surface to divide into anterior medial cerebral artery and anterior cerebral artery. Branches, choroidal artery, crust cerebri, they supply the crust cerebri, lateral geniculate body, obturate parts of the internal capsule. Ophthalmic artery supplies the eye, orbital structures, frontal area of the scalp, ethmoid and frontal sinuses, dorsum of the nose. Posterior communicating artery, the anterior cerebral artery, medial cerebral artery are the branches from the internal carotid. Anterior cerebral artery is smaller terminal branch of the internal carotid. It runs superior to the optic nerve and enters the longitudinal fissure of the cerebrum. Here it is joined anterior cerebral artery of the opposite side by anterior communicating artery. This diagram you can see in the circle of Willis. It then curves backwards over the corpus callosum. See here, anterior cerebral artery. And anastomosis with the posterior cerebral artery. Penetrating branches are the central branches from the anterior cerebral artery, but it supplies the part of the lentiform nucleus, caudate nucleus, and part of the internal capsule. Cortical branches supply the orbital and medial surface of the frontal and parietal lobes up to the parietal occipital sulcus. The strip of the cortex about 1 inch, paracentral lobule, area below knee, and control controls the anal and bladder sphincter. Anticerebral artery, important functional area supplied by the cortical branches. Lobe, frontal lobe, parietal lobe area, motor, lower limb and perineum, pericentral lobule. Sensory, lower limb and perineum, paracentral lobule. Middle cerebral artery is the largest branch from the internal carotid artery. It runs in the lateral sulcus. So, middle cerebral artery, it runs in the lateral sulcus of the brain. The initial part of the middle cerebral artery is known as the stem. As it passes laterally, the stem gives off 6 to 12 small diameter penetrating vessels. Those are lenticulostriate arteries. Then it passes to the lateral surface of the cerebral hemisphere and gives off cortical and superior and inferior branches. Lenticulostriate are the central branches. They arise from the stem of the middle cerebral artery. Supplies a part of the lentiform nucleus, caudate nucleus, and part of the internal capsule. Middle cerebral artery has two divisions, the superior division and inferior division. Central lateral hemiplegia with a significant deviation of the upper limb. Deviation of the eye towards the side of the lesion. Broca's aphasia or motor aphasia. Inferior division, damage results in Wernicke's or sensory aphasia, superior quadriantic hemianopia, visual neglect. Apraxia refers to the inability to perform previously learned tasks despite of preserved strength, vision and coordination. Circle of Willis. The circle of Willis, it lies in the interpeduncular fossa. That is in the base of the brain. So, that is, it is formed by the basilar right internal carotid arteries. And as opposed to between internal carotid and two vertebral arteries, or you can say basilar artery. The anterior communicating artery, you can see here, this is the anterior communicating artery. Anterior cerebral artery, posterior communicating artery, and the basilar artery contribute for the formation of circular fields. It allows the blood to be distributed to any part of both the cerebral hemispheres. The formation, we can see the circular field is anteriorly by anterior communicating artery and the anterior cerebral artery, posteriorly by the basilar artery, dividing into two posterior cerebral arteries, laterally on each side by posterior communicating artery with the posterior cerebral artery, communicating with the posterior cerebral artery. So what is the functional significance of the circular fields? Normally there is a little or no mixing of blood streams of two vertebral arteries in the basilar artery, of two anterocerebral arteries in the anterior communicating artery, or of the internal carotid artery, posterior cerebral arteries in the posterior communicating artery. Therefore, the right half of the brain is supplied by right vertebral and right internal carotid arteries. Left half of the brain supplies the left vertebral and left internal carotid arteries. However, if one of the major arteries forming the circular villus is blocked, the circular villus provides various alternative routes for the collateral circulation, like an arterial traffic circuit. Let's apply to the brainstem. This I have already discussed, the blood supply of the pons, medulla oblongata and the midbrain. We had a separate class for those. Okay. Blood supply of the medulla, anterior spinal artery, posterior spinal artery, vertebral artery, posterior inferior cerebellar artery. All this we have discussed. Blood supply of the cerebellum, it has been discussed in the cerebellum topic. Veins of the brain. Veins of the brain are thin walled. They have no muscular tissue in their wall, no valves, lie in the subarachnoid space, drain into the cranial venous sinuses. We have two groups of veins, the external cerebral veins and internal cerebral veins. So external cerebral veins, the superior cerebral vein, superficial middle cerebral vein, deep middle cerebral vein, pass upward over the lateral surface of the and empty into the superior sagittal sinus. So superior cerebral veins, they empty into the superior sagittal sinus. Superficial middle cerebral vein drains lateral surface, runs lateral sulcus to empty into the cavernous sinus. Middle cerebral vein drains the insula. joined by anterocerebral vein and striate veins to form basal vein, which joins the great cerebral vein to drain into the striate sulcus. Intercerebral veins, two in number, formed by union of thalamus striate vein and choroid vein, runs posteriorly and unites beneath the splenium of the corpus callosum to form cerebral vein. Ultimately, drains into the striate sulcus. Veins of the spinal cord. Veins of the spinal cord, they drain into six tortuous longitudinal channels that communicate superiorly with the skull, with the veins of the brain and venous sinuses. They drain mainly into the intervertebral venous sinuses. So external, we have posterior external venous plexus. Internal, we have posterior internal venous plexus. And the subarachnoid space, we have spinal and choroid plexus in the subarachnoid space. Arterial supply of the internal capsule. This will be discussed in the white matter of the cerebrum. Anterior choroidal, medial striate, lateral striate. So among the blood supply of the brain, we should practice the diagram of circular pilis, and you must know what are the arteries which are taking part in the formation of the circular pilis. Okay, and blood supply of brain is very, very important question. Thank you very much.